Well, it's time for some more F1 on my team, and today we're here for the legendary Monaco Grand Prix, round 4 of the season. Now, before we jump into it, if you guys are new to the channel or you know are new to the series, the last two races, Portugal and Imola, just happened. If you want to see how those new circuits turned out, check out the previous episodes linked up in the top right. And also, you've been given a fair spoiler warning, so yeah, now's your chance to click off the video. If you're new to the channel, if you're going to enjoy the video, leave a like, subscribe for more, and let's jump into the Monaco race weekend. So we're going to jump straight into qualifying here, as there's no real big updates in regards to weather forecast upgrades, so we can just get straight to the action and get it underway. So special helmet, all blue this weekend, you know, in tribute and kind of commemoration to my main channel, of course. And I think it looks quite nice, actually, under the Monaco setting. So big fan of that one as we jump into Q1. Now, soft tyres on the car straight away. Want to try and get through into Q2 with just one set of tyres slash one run. First time lap on the board, 1 minute 7.4. It's going to give us P9. We then got pushed down to P13. So I then went for a second push lap on the same set of tyres. And you can see here we're up and actually purple in the middle sector and up by 0.4 on my previous best lap. We do brush the wall there, but luckily I think we got away with any damage as we go through that RAS cast and now into the final corner, making sure we don't ruin the lap. And now DRS wide open, running up to the start finish, and it's going to be an improvement of 4.5 into a very high 106.9, and we go P6. We then got pushed down to P10, but it was enough to get into Q2. Happy days all round, and Schwartzman up in P4. So car working well. Some of those lap times were a bit inaccurate. There was a bit of time simulation that took place, but we now move into Q2, and we've got the mediums on. And this qualifying session, by the way, is an 100% AI. I've gone up from 96 in the last one to 100 for this one because Monaco is usually a bit of an easier circuit for me as we invalidate at the Nouvelle Chicane. No damage, though, as we just charge up the battery and go for a second lap on these tyres. You can see here we're two and a bit tense up here as we head into La Nouvelle Chicane again, this time not cutting the apex, and we do a good job of avoiding that. Now into Tabac, throwing the car in, but we bash the wall. And then we would get pretty bad damage and invalidate that in the process. So game over for us on the mediums. I had to switch on a set of soft tires. Now, on the softs, of course, plenty more grip. Currently, we're P16 and last. We get through the Nouvelle Chicane. Now, can we get through to back? Yes, we do. A bit of a correction, but we get it done as we're purple in Sector 2. Now into the swimming pool chicane. We get a bit of a moment, but we manage to control the car and keep it steady. Raskas. Nicely done, and then the final corner, back on the gas, opening DRS as we run up to the line, and it's going to be a 1 minute 6.8 for P7, and that will do it for us in this. I did try to go for another qualifying lap, but it wasn't faster, so in the end, we finish in P8, Schwartzman does finish just ahead of us. Bottas has a 5-place grid penalty for Mercedes, so both cars into Q3, and we get in relatively comfortably by a couple of tenths as we jump into the Q3 action. Now, two fresh sets of soft tyres were available to us in this qualifying. The first one, actually, pretty decent. Not a bad banker, but there was a bit more time in the final sector. Across the line, we go with 1 minute 6.7, which is a PB for me so far this weekend. We go P5 behind both Mercedes cars, but I then went for a cooldown lap and then a second push lap on the same tyres. And this one ended up being my best lap in qualifying. So for this one, I'm going to let you guys enjoy the engine sound and appreciate a lap of Monaco in a maxed out My Team car. And there we go, across the line, it's a purple second and third sector. We go P1, provisional pole in qualifying. But as we return to the pits, it turns out we have underbody damage. So if you look at the timer, we don't have enough time to get back out on my final set of soft tires that I have. So unfortunately, that's going to be qualifying over for us. The question is, will that lap be enough? We're currently equal on lap time with Verstappen. And at the end of Q3, Max did improve along with Pierre Gasly. So we're going to start the race from P3. Schwartzman P7, but with Bottas's penalty, he's going to start from P6. And generally speaking, that's a decent qualifying. I don't mind that. Verstappen, of course, the championship leader. So important that we try and beat him in the race. But P3, another strong qualifying, this time on 100% AI. And yeah, we're now going to move into the race here for round 4 at the Principality in Monaco.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And it's Pierre Gasly in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Martinez, Perez, Lando Norris, and Schwartzman, Leclerc, Sainz, Ricciardo, and George Russell, Bottas, Tsunoda, Sebastian Vettel, and Ocon, Giovinazzi, Ilott, Nobuharu Matsushita, and Christian Lundgaard, Mick Schumacher, Latifi, Stroll, and Nikita Mazepin. It's almost time for those 5 red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
Here we are then for the Monaco Grand Prix. Usually not the most entertaining race. The main event for me is usually qualifying on Saturday, but we're going to try and make it a decent race nonetheless. We start from P3, Verstappen on pole, Gasly P2, and of course our main rival Max is ahead of us, so we want to make sure we try to beat him here today because he is the leader of the championship, and I want to try and, of course, not let him get away too much if I can avoid it. So we're going to try and be aggressive both on track and on strategy here today. Speaking of which, we're going to start, of course, on the soft tyres that we qualified on. We're then going to switch to a medium tyre. It's looking like a one-stop strategy around here, to be honest with you. We can go for the hard tyre if necessary. Fuel-wise, I've gone for the lowest, and that equates to almost 6 laps negative of fuel, which is a lot less fuel. But the car, as you guys know, is super, super efficient on fuel now. So I've learned my lesson. It will run minimum every single time. So, yeah, we're going to jump into it. Hopefully, with that minimum fuel, the car should be very, very agile. So, yeah, I'm banking on the car being quick, especially on this first part of the race. So let's jump into it. Let's try and be aggressive, and let's see if we can try and get ahead of Verstappen possibly in this race. Right, let's do this. The lights are on here at Monaco. Quick 5 lights, and we're underway. Bit of a snap there on the race start. Gasly challenging Verstappen here for the lead, and Max is a bit slow off the corner, which may give us the invitation to have a little look into Massenet side by side with Verstappen. We're going to have to leave some space on the inside, and we just get ahead. There we go. Crucial, crucial move. Verstappen having a poor start. Gasly, the surprise race leader. But we've got the crucial move that we need. Now we can try to win this race, hopefully. I'm not underestimating Gasly's pace, but I know for a fact that Verstappen was leading, he would be running away with it. So, very important move. Even if we finish like this race, I'll be more than happy. But a big shout out to Pierre for getting that start, because that's really helped us out. Now then, let's see if we can keep pace. Pierre trying to stretch early on. Of course, Monaco requires ultimate concentration, and it's all about rhythm and flow. You know, you need to get into the zone around here and get into a bit of momentum. So essentially, lap after lap after lap, try and build up that confidence without making any big mistakes. So I'm going to go away now for a bit and try and do my thing and focus on the race in hand, and we'll see what happens. Schwartzman, though, up to P5 as well. So decent start from our teammate, getting himself up another place. But yeah, let's go after Pierre, who's trying to break away here. Right, now is when the race begins. We're on lap 3. The AI usually stop running engine mode on lap 3. They usually run it for the first 2 laps to try and break out of DRS. So now we're going to see what Gasly's true pace is. He was faster than me on the last lap, so fair play. We'll see if we can try and get the gap down. I'm keeping an eye on my temperatures. Not going too hard on the tyres right now, but it does seem like we're not going to have any issues with tyre temps this race. So we can go ahead and push. I'm running the lowest temperatures possible on the tyre pressures, so that should help us out. But yeah, right now I'm still kind of building up my confidence, essentially. in this race. Not pushing too crazy right now, but this should be a personal best, and not quite. I lost it in the final corner there, which is a bit of a shame.
We're in danger of running out of fuel before the end of the race. Start being a little conservative with the remaining fuel, please.
Don't worry, Jeff. Shut up, Jeff.
Confirmed.
There we go, thank you very much. There we go. Personal best, fastest lap of the race. Bit of a stronger final sector there, as we now start to make some progress. You can see Verstappen can't quite keep up, surprisingly. So it seems like Gasly genuinely has some very good pace around here, so it is legit. But now we've got to try and find a way through. Rear tyre wear already starting to kick in as we approach 20% of the rears. Could come down to strategy and pit stop timing. If we go long, that might be the better option. But I'd like to pass him on track on merit, to be honest.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Copy.
We'll go for that. We'll go longer in the race. I think the overcut is going to be the way to go. Quite close to Gasly this time. The closest I've been so far this race. Let's see if we can line something up in this final sector. It's not easy to follow because you can't see the curbs or the walls when you get too close to another car. Through the Raskas, easy does it. Messed up my final corner a little bit there. Didn't quite get the entry right. Wasn't close enough to the apex. Can we get close? Had a little look there, a little feint. But Gasly didn't buy it. Got to be careful with the tyre temps by overworking the rears too much with those kind of moves. Oh, Gas has a bit of a moment. Can I set him up? That's a bit better. Slightly closer this time. Can we have a look? Not quite. Need to be even closer than that. Gasly gets very good traction at the final corner. Oh, this is close. I thought about going for the Raskas overtake. The AI don't really seem to leave that gap open anymore nowadays. They seem to have closed that with patches and stuff. We're closer again on the pit straight though. This could be the one. Have a look around the outside. Yes, get the drive. There it is. We've done it. Race lead, baby. Up to P1. On track as well. Exactly what you want. And now we've got a clean track ahead of us. Fuel saving going pretty well. 4.5 laps. Looks like we're going to be well on target for fuel. But now let's see if we have any tyres left to try and pull away a little bit and open up a gap. To be fair, the pack is fairly spread out. There's been a lot of incidents and controversy elsewhere. The overcart wasn't really going to work, looking at the minimap, to be fair. So we can afford to pit whenever we want and basically cover off the undercut. But Gas, as you can see, dropping off the pace here quite badly. So this was our scheduled pit stop lap. We're going to go for lap 13. Gasly's going to pit, and so is Verstappen. Okay, interesting. We're going to try and stick to the strategy here. I think I've got pace. It will depend where they rejoin. I'll keep an eye on the minimap and see where they are. I was going to pit this lap to cover off the undercut, but I'm going to pit now, next lap, sorry, for Schwartzman's sake. I hope he pits right now. I've got a feeling this would have been his scheduled pit stop lap because my original lap was lap 11. I'm doing this to not ruin Schwartzman's race. And there we go, I guessed it.
Robert is coming in for his stop.
It's important for me that we get points as a team, so I want Schwartzman to not have his race ruined, especially around a track where you can't overtake. I can sit out one more. The pace isn't terrible, but we're going to pit this lap. Right, here we go. Into the Raskas. This is going to be close, to be fair, but hopefully we do enough. Right, let's see. Medium tyres ready. We're going to rejoin somewhere around Gasly Vettel, I think. It's going to be really close. We may have to overtake or be racy on the exit. There seems to be a good stop from the boys now more than ever. It's not good. 2.7, it's not that fast, but I think we're going to be okay. I think we're going to be P1 still. Here comes George on the hard tyre. Up to speed we go. There is Ross, you can see the arrow. Through the pit exit we go. And I'm going to put the afterburners on here. Stay ahead. There we go, that's worked out beautifully. So we've got a couple laps fresh in mediums compared to Max and Pierre. And we rejoined the head of this little bit of three-car traffic that they got stuck behind. And Schwartzman also had a free stop. Didn't lose any time, so win-win. We can keep driving now and doing our thing. But that was a really crucial phase of the race, which has turned out pretty much perfectly for us. So we can now just drive away and do our thing. Well, we're on for a personal best and a new fastest lap by the looks of it. Car feels fantastic. Really, really good this race. I think I got the setup spot on, to be honest. this weekend. That's really helped me. I've struggled in this game to get the setup right around Monaco, especially with the My Team car. It's really difficult, but I've got it perfect around here this weekend as we set a low 8, which is a very, very good lap. What a lap. That is absolutely insane. I've just found another half a second from nowhere into the 107s. I could just drive this car, man. It feels fantastic. I think I should put the AI up higher, to be fair. I'm on 102. And qualifying was on 100. I should have maybe gone as close to 110, maybe even 110 around here, in fairness, but I underestimated the AI. They're just hard to predict nowadays with the inconsistency in terms of their performances, so this is also a downside of me going down on difficulty quite a lot. The easier races may be easier, but luckily we don't have many of these. I think only Mexico, we got rid of Singapore for obvious reasons, so yeah, should only be this one really in Mexico, but I've learned my lesson, so Mexico will be up to par. Well, the midfield runners have done such a good job for us, you know, holding up the faster guys, Russell, Tsunoda and Vettel, that we can now pit for a second time if necessary and still come out in the lead. We've got the gap that we need, so they've lost so much time. I mean, the slow traffic has ruined Gasly and Verstappen's race, which is why it's so crucial to overtake them, you know, and be ahead of them on strategy, and that's what we did. The fine margins make a big difference around here. So yeah, right now we're chilling this race. We just got to bring the car home. I swear to God, I do not want an engine failure this race. Oh my God, that was close. Whoa. Back end there did not want to work. That was a scary moment. I'm going to try and take a little bit out of my driving. I'm pushing for no reason, to be honest. But also, when you're driving solo for a long time, you tend to lose focus because you're not really concentrating. You're just kind of going through the motions. So I've got to be careful to not make any mistakes now more than ever. So Sebastian Vettel finally pits, releasing all the traffic. And look how far behind they are. 33 seconds. Absolutely insane. Look at the train on the minimap, by the way. You can see where they all are. It's actually crazy how much time they've all lost. We've got a yellow flag up ahead, I think. Someone's retiring. Hopefully not a safety car, because it's going to reduce my entire gap. If it is a safety car, then we'll pit. I just brushed the wall there by accident. Giovinazzi's blown up. That's where you get past.
Be careful with the front wing. You've taken some minor damage. Tire condition is still looking good.
Okay, we're going to pit then. In that case, got some damage. We might as well come in. I thought I brushed the wall. I thought I brushed it. Just got a bit distracted there by Giovinazzi. I didn't really pay attention. So we'll get our front wing change. We should still be out ahead. We've got plenty cushion to Gasly. That's the whole point. We've got a free pit stop, so we might as well take it. I've got a fresh set of softs as well from qualifying because we didn't get our final run in. So come on, guys. A bit quicker than this, please. And away we go, 9.1. I was a bit slow on the pull away, but we're going to be out comfortably in the lead. Got soft tires on the wagon. And there we go, we survive a little scare. Right at the end there, just getting distracted by Giovinazzi's retiring car. Luckily, I checked the vehicle condition, sim damage. You know, sometimes you get damage without even realising, hence why you need to ask on the radio. Any kind of brush against the wall is important. But yeah, we've cleared that little hurdle, so let's just bring this one home now, the last 10 laps or so. I might try for one push lap on these tires, but that's it. Well, this is going to be one very fast lap. Completely messed up the Raskas, but still it's going to be easily fastest. Purple, and it's going to be an improvement. Not as much as I thought, but a solid half second will do. And that's it for me this race. We're now going to just bring this one home. I don't want any engine failures. I just want to try and get this over the line. Well, you can send it out the race. Another car out. Now down to 20 runners, yep, in this race. Not going to affect us though, too late for a safety car I think, so we're going to be absolutely fine. Just easing this one home now. And there we go, we've just got the fuel now to tick over to positive, so the fuel's pretty much perfect to be honest with you. Negative 6 laps seems to be the amount we need per race to go perfect for fuel. So there we go, with a couple laps to spare we've done it. Well here we go, last lap of the race. It's been a very, very comfortable race for us once we got past Verstappen and Gasly. Obviously, it helps that they got held up really, really badly by a three-car block on the all strap. But still, the pace was good. Car was phenomenal. The best the car's ever felt around here. And we've unlocked the pace. But a second win of the season, and we win in Monaco.
Well, all right. I think maybe I can start turning some of these assists off.
It wasn't always plain sailing today, but a very important win nonetheless. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on the track was today, speed. I know it sounds like an obvious thing to say, Crofty, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way out onto the podium.
Well, that just looks good, doesn't it? You know, the race suit in the winner's bracket right there on the left, and a full 26 points here today, including a fastest lap, which is really, really big for the championship. Pierre Gasly, P2, holds on and keeps Verstappen behind, who finishes P3. Perez, P4 in the second Red Bull, Schwartzman, P5, and then it's Norris in the first of the Mercedes, and then Sainz, Leclerc, Russell, and Sebastian Vettel rounding out the top 10. Out of the points, Ocon, Ilott, Bottas, of course, two-stopped it and had that five-place grid penalty. Matsushita, Ricciardo, Stroll, Lundgaard, Latifi, Mazepin, Schumacher, and then Tsunoda and Giovinazzi out of the race. Now then, after that one, and the fact that we got P1 with the fastest lap and Verstappen got P3, it means we take the championship lead after four rounds, and we are 4 points ahead of Verstappen, 16 clear of Perez. Schwartzman loses out to P6 to Pierre Gasly, but still equal in points, and a pretty close battle actually between Bottas, Norris, Gasly and Schwartzman there further back. In the constructors, we're still second, but we close the gap to Red Bull to 19 points. So we're closing in, making progress, and hopefully we can keep it going that way. But anyway, that's going to be it for the race here in Monaco. We're now going to move into... Actually, do we move into the laptop? I think we've done all the upgrades we need. I think we're done, you know. We've got one more to go, but I don't think we need to go into the laptop anymore because there's no real need. Any laptop work we'll just do at the start of the episodes from now on, I think. So, you know what? I'm going to call it here and say that's it for today's race at Monaco. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, subscribe for more. Let's try to smash over 1,200 likes for the race win at Monaco and the perfect overtakes and strategy. As always, the channel members, massive shout out to you guys for supporting the content. Finally, check out the two videos on screen if you haven't seen them. But that is it from me here at the Principality, and I'll see all of you in the next one. Until then, take care, and let's goodbye from me.